हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर एस बी गोल्ले, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, शिवाजी आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज कन्नड, डिस्ट्रिक्ट औरंगाबाद। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक जियो थर्मल एनर्जी। नाउ फ्रेंड्स, सी इन दिस इमेज जियो थर्मल पावर प्लांट इज शोन। नाउ एंशंट पीपल यूज्ड दिस जियो थर्मल एनर्जी फॉर बाथिंग, कुकिंग एंड फॉर हीटिंग पर्पज। Italians built an electric generator at Lardarello in 1904. In United States, it was built in 1922. Now, 21 countries are using this geothermal energy to produce electricity. Now, one question may come in your mind: what is geothermal energy? The name implies geo plus thermal. Geo means earth, thermal means energy generated and stored in the earth. It is called geothermal energy. Now, what are the resources of this geothermal energy? Hot water reservoirs of varying temperatures and depth below the earth's surface are the three sources. We can use these resources to produce electricity and for other purposes also. Now friends, there are steps to extract this geothermal energy from earth below the earth's surface. First is extraction. Hot water is pumped out from deep subsoil. Heat exchanger extract heat from that hot water, and the cooled water is then again sent back to earth. In this image we can also see there are two pipes. One is for pumping out the hot water, and then there is heat exchanger which extracts heat from that hot water, and remaining water is sent back to earth by another pipe. Now, generation of electricity. Friends, types of geothermal power plants for generation of electricity: first is dry steam power plant, second is flash steam power plant, third is binary cycle power plant. Now we will see one by one. First is dry steam power plant. Now friends, dry steam, this plant utilizes dry steam, means water vapor. It extracts steam at around temperature 150 degrees Celsius. It collects rising steam which is funneled directly to turbine which drives the generator, and it gives us electricity. In this image we can also see that turbine, that pipe, rising steam pipe, and then it is fed to that turbine, and then it drives the generator, and again finally we get electricity. Second plant is flash steam power plant. Flash steam is used in this power plant. It utilizes water at around 182 degrees Celsius. Means here high pressure, high temperature water is fed to flash tanks where it is converted to steam to run the power generator set. It is shown in this figure. Third is binary cycle power plant. It requires water at around 57 degrees Celsius to heat separate fluid. Here in this case, fluid used is butane or pentane hydrocarbon. So friends, see in this image, hot water is drawn up two different set of pipes. Heat exchanger then transfers this energy of hot water to working fluid. Mean the main work of heat exchanger is to extract heat from this hot water and finally to give that heat to working fluid, which is butane or pentane hydrocarbon. Then the vapor from the working fluid, because we have given heat to working fluid, so vapor from the fluid working fluid passes through the turbine and it is recondensed and piped back to heat exchanger. The fluid drives the turbine, it rotates it, and electricity is generated and remaining heat is piped back to heat exchanger. Now, what is status of geothermal energy in India? So, friends, 350 geothermal energy locations in the country have been identified by Geological Survey of India. The most promising of this is in Piga Valley of Ladakh. And the estimated potential of this energy in India is about 10,000 megawatt. There are 7 geothermal spots in India. The Himalayas, Sohana, West Coast, Kembe, San Narmada Tapi, Godavari and Mahanadi. These are the spots. Now, what are the advantages and disadvantages of this geothermal energy? First advantage is, it is clean source. You know, it does not emit pollutants. It is sustainable source. It is non-exhaustible source. No fuel combustion is needed. Economically sound. Now, what are disadvantages of this? High installation cost. It requires high installation cost. Again, there is problem of transportation of electricity, because from this point of production of electricity, we have to carry this electricity to cities or industry purpose, industrial area. We need transportation, not widespread source. It is not present everywhere. We have to choose spots where we can extract this energy. It is not everywhere. Steam may run out. That is also important, because if steam runs out, then it will not be beneficial for this. Thank you.